Hi, welcome to this new video tutorial, and today we are going to continue with the next part of our previous video where we built the front end, and right now we are going to implement the back end. And before going into the detail, let me show you what we'll expect at the end of this tutorial. So at the end of this tutorial here, you will be able to run your applications with local IP, and then using HTTPS here, as you can see here. So you are going to be able to set up the local certificate, and then start our video like this one. And then, yeah, once that one is done here, I'm going to start again one instance from my mobile applications. And I just start my local client now. Now I'm going to launch a call from my mobile device. I launch it here, then you are going to get like accept incoming call. So that is it. If you accept the incoming call, so you can see here right now that this is how you get it. So I don't want to show you the front of so just for the sake of privacy here, so you will get something like this one. And as you can see here, this is from my mobile device. So that is what you'll be able to get at the end of this tutorial. And then, yeah, so after that one, we can hang up. So that is it. And then how to do this one? Let's go into the theory. So if we just take this one down, that's it. Oh, I just close my recorder. Okay, the recording is there. Yeah, save this. Okay, then so how to achieve this one? And before continuing here, we are implementing now the back end. Here is the back end. And in the previous tutorial, we stopped here. And then it's important to know some of the key terms. Some of the key terms here are very important to know for the back end implementations. So I don't know like what would be the best way of doing this one. And we have the stone server, so let's do this way. So I will take and try to draw it. So suppose that we have one client here. This is my laptop, and then here is another client here, which is accessing from a mobile device. And so we need, here is our peer, we say that this is our peer connections. This will be some objects that we will need in our backend. So here is our peer connections. Of course, later on we are going to establish a full connections here. So before establishing these full connections here, right, so these connections here can be either, usually we are going to, this peer connections here is going to be a UDP connections, which is more suitable for real-time communications. However, that one may fall back to the TCP connections whenever it's an error. But usually now, we are behind some firewalls. Suppose this is here, our firewalls here. Then, in order for this client here to go through the web and discover the other client here, we are going to make use of storm server. So each client here will, this is our storm. This is our storm server. Here is also the storm server here. So what this storm server does, so it allows a client to discover its public IP. Currently now, I have my computer which is connected to the web. I know my local IP if I enter IP config, so I will get my local IP, but I don't know my real IP. So during this one, so what is the client will request? This storm server. Oh, can you give me my public IP and ports? So it sent a request, sent in this way. And then it return its it will return its public IP address. So, and that public IP address here is of course very important for discovering clients over the web. So that is the use of the storm server, if I can explain it this way. And then secondly now, then we have this one. I will continue with offer and answers. So each time you want to make a connection, we need to a client which is initiating the connections here will send a message to propose the connections. And that message is called offer. So that is the offer. And then the remote client here, whenever it receives the message, the offer sent by the initiator here, then it will reply with the answer. So locally here, we have the offer which is sent by this client, and then remotely here, you have the answer. So you send the offer and then you receive the answer. That is it. And yeah, so that is it now. And once that one is done, so in order to get, so in order for this client to know exactly, like I am here, so how can this client here, possibly remote client here, possibly know that where to find me over the web? So in order to do that, this client here, the peer connections here need to create what is called ICE candidates. The ICE candidates here. And then what this ICE candidate contain is it contain the IP, it contain a potential network route and port, IP plus port here. You know, eh? You know the socket is equal IP plus port. So it contain these crucial informations that if someone knows your public IP and port, then the person can connect to you. So how do we send, so this IP, this connections here will create the ICE candidate for this client. And then he has to put it somewhere. Or we have to find a way. So how will this one knows where this client is? So with your as candidate, you are saying that, hey, if you want to find me over the web, here is my information on how to find me. Then the client now will need somewhere, very important, we need to find somewhere, a common place where if you take this one and send it over the emails, someone can take your as candidate over the emails and then connect to you. If you send it by post, someone will take it, put it in the computer or whatever, and then find you. So very important here is where our signaling server comes in. So right now you'll have what is called the signaling server. What we are going to implement, of course, there are some open source. We'll do the implementation of that in another part, but here is our signaling server. Then the signaling server help exchanging set of informations between peers. So now a client now, so this is a signaling server, we can just say like it's a portal or a website. So if I want to connect to Zoom, then I need to go to Zoom website. I will go there. This one will go here, create a meeting, and then this send a link, and then the client come there, and it is on Zoom that everyone meets, but not like a Zoom lesson, it's a website, where I can take my ICE candidate informations, put it in a website, and someone can go copy it there and connect to me. So just take it as a central website where everyone come and meet. So then now, here is where this RTC session descriptions come into play. This one will contain a type. This will have a type and then the SDP. So these objects here has a type and the ICE, these objects, ITC session descriptions here represent, is an object that represent your connections details. So when the client want to send, will put its ICE candidate here in this session descriptions. And the type here can be offer or the answer. So the client now send its this RTC session descriptions to the signaling server, and then here will be of type offer. And another term that I forgot to add here is a local offer, remote offer, local answers, remote answer, right? So and so the client here will send this RTC session descriptions here of that local offer with the ICE candidate. So here is that here. So it sends this local offer to the signaling server. Then the signaling server will take it and then forward it to forward it as remote offer to the remote client. So the core client will receive it, then create a remote answer, create a remote as a form of acknowledgement. So create a remote. Here is our remote answer. Then forward it here, and this one will receive it. Signal the server, take the remote answer and make here a local. So this one will take here, sorry, this one will create a local answer here, sorry, the remote client here create a local answer, then the signaling server will take it and forward it here as remote answers. So we have here local offer, the signaling server, remote offer, then local answer, remote answer. And once this one is done here, then we have a full connections has been established. So once this full connections is established now, after all these transactions now, then now we can take tracks. We take tracks which are individual media stream. We can put this track here over our connections. Track like the one from the railway, and it's on this track now that we can exchange data, audio, video that we query here. Remember in this get user media here, where you have camera, phone, data here, then we can exchange these informations now. And this one, of course, is through UDP. But whenever there's a fallback, then it might go to the TCP connections, depending on how our implementation is. So this is a bit, you may correct me if I'm wrong, but this is a bit my understanding. A bit short theory of the whole thing. So once this one is set, we can go into the more details. And of course, you can also come here to RTC MSDN, RTC M Microsoft Developer Network, and if you come here to this portal here, of course you are going to find all these things that we just talked about, like the signaling server and the definitions of the signaling servers and some of the import SNP code. Everything that we are doing here, you will find everything here in the API. So then, after we finish that one, and it is time now to go to the coding, and then I will bring our code that we started yesterday. We started it yesterday. So, and we need now to set up, we are going to set up, we create our signaling server, and then in order to do that, in order to create our signaling server, we are going to create here a new folder that we call server. Here is our server, and then inside that we are going to create a file call signal server.js. Signal server.js. So this one will be this one is going to be our signal server, and then so that's our signal server file, and then we need to add some code into it. But before continuing here, I have to set, as you have seen here, we are using HTTP because we need to. It is important when dealing with this, especially if you are planning to use mobile for testing or using some other device around. Remote device for testing to use is HTTPS. Otherwise, you are going to have restrictions in pulling, in querying the local media and start doing stuff. If you are planning to do like this multimedia applications here, you need to deal with HTTPS. But here you are going to create our local HTTPS. We need to create our local HTTPS. And then the first thing that we have to do now is to set up our local HTTPS. Then, in order to do that, we are going to make use of Mkcert. This Mkcert. Here is the Mkcert. We are going to make use of this package here, and then of course we have the GitHub also here. It's a bit older, right? It's a bit older, but this one allows us to set up the local HTTPS where we can do the testing. So in order to do that now, we are going to use you need, if you are on Windows, like this one, and then you will need to type this shoko install. You need to type this shoko install, then it's going to install it. If it doesn't work, then you can use who, depending on what you are using. So mine here, I use Shoko to install it, and during the installations here, during the installations, you'll be prompted to accept some stuff. And then I already have this one installed in my system, and then I'm not going to but this is what I got here. So you do shoko install, and then blah 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 here, probably, and of course you need to open this one, very important here, you open this one as the command prompt as with elevated privilege as administrator. And then we do this one, install it. So after installing here, you may run this mkcert install again to make sure that it's properly installed. Then once that one is done, and we can come now. You'll have something like Mkcert version CL. So this is the version that I have now. So it means that my Mkcert is properly installed. Then we need to create our certificates. In order to do that now, we come here, integrated terminal, right? And then we are going to create that one with special arguments. Here is localhost with double quotes, and here is my IP. And this IP here, and you type it using IP config. So I don't want to show you my network information, but let me IP config. So let me take a screenshot of that. Very important. So we get our IP configurations. Then after that, I have to add my informations. Then you are going to get something like this one, and then you are going to take this IP version. So this is a local address here. So this is what you have taken to put here. By typing IP config, IP config is this one. Config. So we create this one, we get our local IP. Then now we are going to create the local certificates. Then, as you can see here, two files are created. Here is the pen, here is the key, and here is our certificate here. And here is the key. So we have these two files created, and then once those two files are created, then now we can now go to the implementations. Now we have our local certificates ready for recording. And then now let's start. And all these codes here can be found in the MSDN. So const file here, we need to access our file here. We need to access this certificates here in our code. So we need require file certificates. This file system, and then also need HTTPS require this one, and HTTPS, right, this one. And here we are using WebSocket to implement our signaling server, and we could also use Socket IO. I will do a different video on that, how to create that with Socket IO. And then here we have our WebSocket required. Socket. these three are defined, then now we need to load our certificates and the key. So load certif and key. So you have to do that here, and then we need also to have load our key. In order to load our key here, required sync, this one, and then our key is this one. We go to rename, copy this, localhost. So, and remember, because these are both of them in the same directory, we don't need to put anything here, but in case you save this somewhere else, then make sure that you put the correct path to your file. And same thing we are going to do with certificate. So same thing here, we copy this one, put it here. What is that? This one, right? Localhost plus one, perms, and then here is our certificates. Then going down now, we need to create an HTTPS server. So in O, we have to create other constants. HTTPS server equal here HTTPS create server, and then inside that you are going to paste our key and certificates. So here is our HTTPS server that we have created. Now let us create a WebSocket server wrapped around the HTTPS server. Then we create our WebSocket now. Cons WebSocket equal WebSocket here. WebSocket dot WebSocket dot server, WebSocket dot server, and then inside that server we are going to set this equal HTTP. Our HTTPS server here, we put it here. So our WebSocket server is ready now for use, and then because of permissions issue, then we need to add our COS to the WebSocket handshake. So then for adding, very important here, you know, in web development is over important for security issues. And then inside this one now we have, so on connections here we pass the header, the listener here, our listener, call it headers, and then create a local variables headers. one, and then for the headers here, we are going to push the following insight. So access control here, allow origin from everything, content type here, and the method. So here is that stage, which is over. And then next thing now is to handle the messaging. For handling the messages now, we have the broadcast. We have to broadcast the message. All these connections is established now. We need to broadcast. We need to broadcast some messages to all clients which are connected. So for that one, you need a WebSocket. You need a WebSocket and data variables. That one. So now each time that we have a call, for each time that we have a new client connections here, we have each current for all clients connected here. Is that WS.clients? For each client, so here's the client here. Then we have so if the client here. If client is not the server, so you cannot connect to yourself. So here, if not the server, and client, whatever, client. State equal WebSocket open. So it should be listening to the port, right? It should be listening to the port of our signal server. Then this one here. So we have to make sure that the message is serialized. So ensure that it is serialized before sending. Sometimes we may get some not good message which are not serialized. So in order to do that one here, const json data here, you have a local variable here, type of check the data type is string. JSON string file. Make sure that this is string. And then we have a client sent JSON data. And of course here you have one error here, when does it, where, oh sorry, I put here, okay, that was the error. So that's our broadcasting, and then on connections now. We have to add another listener on add listener. We have to add another listener here on connections here. This one. This one we are going to add now. So it is this is the format that we use. Same thing that we have here. So I will have another connections WebSocket variable here. Then interesting. So the first thing that we have here now on connections now is to show how many clients are connected. Lock client connected. Total. We need to put a special character. This backslash, this, no, this is forward here. Yeah. This back characters. Access this one now. WebSocket clients size. This is the number of clients which are connected. Each time that we connect, we are going to log the number of connected clients. Then we need to handle the incoming messages. So in order to handle the incoming messages here, we need to create other listeners. These are sub listeners here. If this is a message, so let me need to have a local variable here. Let receive. Message received. Or receive message. And then this one, I don't want, yeah. So if this a buffer, for now you can take it like this one, you have to check if it's a buffer. If you remove this one, you are going to run into some issues where the message that is being received is not a string, but it's a buffer. Then you have to check that. We have to check that here. So here you are checking that. And we assigned receive message. This one. If it's a buffer here, so we have to convert it to a string. To string. To string here. Else received is a string, then we don't need to do anything, so that is it. And then after that one is done, we need to lock. So lock. Need to lock the message here. Received message from client. Colon. Here is the message that we received. We just log it in the console too. And sorry, just a received message here. So then we need to broadcast to all other clients. So first the server receive it. If we send one client, send it to the server, we receive it, and then we forward it to other connected clients. And in order to send to everyone, we need to use broadcasting. And broadcasting here, then we send to everyone except ourselves. So, received that here. Then so that one is done with our messaging. Now we need to handle the disconnections. So in case of disconnections, yeah, this is still a sub event listener. So we are handling now, after the connections is done, we establish the connections, we handle the messages, and then we also have another event here, which is close. Here. Is that then what we need to do now is just to include this like that, and for login purposes, in case of error here, we have to log it, and of course we use the back. the attention here. This is a bug, bug code. Clients. Disconnected. Then, and as above here, total. Connected client. Normally this one should decrease. Connected clients, this number will decrease each time that we disconnect. And then in order to have a size now, we need to access our WebSocket clients size. That is it. And the same thing, we need also to handle the errors. So we copy the same thing. But here, even here will be the error. And then here is the error. And we can display the error here. It is, and collected. It's okay. Then now, after everything is done now, we need to start listening. We need to start our HTTPS server. So, start our HTTPS server. In order to do that, HTTP server dot listen, and then here we are going to listen on port 8081. And because we use IPs, then you have to use 000. This is all ranges, IP ranges. Then if that one is done, we are almost there. And then what we just have to do now is to just copy this and paste it here, and then here we are going to write web WebSocket signaling. Server is run on HTTPS. Here we have that is it. And then you are there. So now in order to run now to run our servers here, we have to make use of Node. Node. make sure that I have my mode. If not there, you can install it. And then mode. Signal and server. And you have one error here. Okay. We have here is a server. This one create a new. Oh, sorry, this WebSocket with I have to set this one with capital S. So start this. See, we have two errors. And not found. Okay, here is you have one dot here, extra dot. Sorry, and then in it here, so this one should be ready, state not rested. And then let's run it again. Bam! So our second cell is wrong. So here is how we could implement our signal server. And then, yeah, so as a recapitulations here, we have done a small tuning, and then we have set up our local certificates here using Mkcert. And then we have also created our signal server and run it, and it's run. So of course there are some open source stuff that we could use, but here we want to understand the basics. Then you are going to stop here, and then in the next part we will continue. We'll continue with the implementations of service of. We are going to create another new service here where all the service we are going to handle will handle the outgoing and incoming. So we are going to handle the outgoing and incoming messages in the next tutorial. So be patient, stay tuned, and then here you can see one client is connected here, but this is from